suspected terrorist was killed in an encounter with security forces on Friday in Avantipura in Pulwama district. Police identified the terrorist as Ishfaq Yusuf Wani, a resident of Pulwama. Wani was wanted for his involvement in a series of terror crimes, including attacks on security establishments and civilian atrocities. Arms and ammunition and incrimination materials were recovered from the site. Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh today said that the current situation in Jammu and Kashmir is an outcome of a series of blunders by the successive Congress government in the state, starting with the Nehruvian blunder. Participating in the debate on a statutory resolution for proclamation of President's rule in the state, Singh said everyone feels the pain of the people of the state. Former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti today hit out at the National Investigation Agency for declaring suspects as terrorists on the basis of Sootli bombs. In a series of tweets, Mehbooba alleged that the urban Naxal case was falling apart. The NIA, in a series of raids, had arrested 10 individuals for operating a sleeper cell for allegedly planning attacks and serial blasts in New Delhi and other parts of the North India. National Conference leader Farooq Abdullah today questioned in the Lok Sabha the Jammu and Kashmir governor's decision to dissolve the state assembly. Voicing concern over the situation in the Kashmir Valley, he also advocated talks with Pakistan for restoration of peace. The former Jammu and Kashmir chief minister made these remarks while participating in the debate on statutory resolution for proclamation of president's rule in Jammu and Kashmir. Lok Sabha on Friday adopted a resolution on imposition of president's rule in Jammu and Kashmir, with the centre asserting that it was committed to democratic process in the state after the opposition termed the decision to dissolve the assembly as unconstitutional. However, after members insisted, Speaker Sumitra Mahajan allowed a discussion on the issue as a special case. NS Jamwal Inspector General on Friday took over the command of BSF Frontier Jammu. He has succeeded Ram Avtar, IG, who has been posted to BSF Academy, Tikanpur. Prior to this appointment, Jamwal has commanded for 2 years most versatile Mizoram and Kachar Frontier of BSF in the northeast region of India, where he coordinated the operational and logistic support to BSF troops deployed in one of the most difficult terrain in the country. Jamwal, a 1984 batch direct entry BSF cadre officer, belonged to J&K State. Jammu and Kashmir police is set to get non-lethal pepper ball launching systems and anti-riot gas masks to deal with the law and other situation in the state. The department has floated tenders for seeking technical bid for manufacturers and dealers of these two products. Heartbreaking cold continued on Friday in both Jammu and Srinagar cities as intense cold wave lashed Jammu and Kashmir. The minimum temperature in Jammu was 2.6 degrees Celsius on Friday, while is the lowest in the season, while Srinagar's minimum temperature settled at minus 7.7 degrees Celsius, which is the lowest in 28 years. The indefinite chain dharna kick started by the SOS International Organization for Pakistan-Occupied Kashmir displaced person on Friday entered second day two of agitation, led by Professor Anand Sharma against alleged discriminatory approach of government during dealing with the issues of POK-DPS who lost their everything during tribal invasion in the erstwhile ancestral places. The protesters criticized and displaced aggression against government over dropping disparity among displaced communities. Congress observes its 134th Foundation Day with Rahul Gandhi hoisting the party's flag at its headquarters in New Delhi today. The event at the Congress Akbar Road office was attended by senior party leaders. Gandhi later said he acknowledged the selfless service and contribution of Congress workers who helped build the party over the years. Need-based workers and casual labourers of the Power Development Department held strong protest demonstration outside the office of Chief Engineer near Canal Road, Jammu today. A large number of temporary workers of the PDD under the banner of J&K PDD Need-based or Casual Labourers Union of Jammu Province started protest demonstration in front of the office of Chief Engineer PDD. They were shouting slogans against the higher authorities in the state and demanding release of their pending wages. 8-day-long Rath Kardha Mela commenced at Narsingdas Temple Gagwal in Samba district today. Thousands of people drawn from neighbouring Punjab, Himachal Pradesh states and other parts of Jammu region participated in the Mela, which started with taking out a Shobha Yatra. The Mela is linked to Pandav period and the Narsingdas Temple was constructed by Dogra rulers. Besides Gagwal, the Mela is held at four places in Ramgarh Tehsil of Udhampur district, Parnala village in Bilawar Tehsil and Hatli village in Kathua. We'll be right back.